first question I have for you is, what were you doing in the meeting this morning? What were you doing? I came into work this morning at like 6:45. I look in the conference room, and there's Terry in the meeting with all the producers and the talent for Get Up.
Hey, I'm dedicated.
That's commitment.
You know, I'm trying to have a career after my career, so you know.
Yeah, I mean, it's the 6 a.m. meeting. Yeah, they make you. They don't even make you do that on the Celtics.
See, it's crazy. They told me 7 o'clock last night. Then they changed it to 6. So I was here.
I walked in the door because we have a glass conference room. I had to look twice. I was like, "Is he?" I was like, "What's he doing here?"
Yeah, I don't remember the last time I had to wake up there.
Well, I really appreciate you doing it. I'm sure that changed your plans last night. And I heard you on Get Up. You did a great job, you know, breaking down the game and your future. And one thing you mentioned that you're going to take a little time off. So my curiosity for you is like, what is the travel plans like? Like, do you go on vacation? You going overseas? Who do you bring with you? What's the plan?
Well, I know I usually always go to Miami, you know, L.A., Vegas, you know, obviously the nice cities. And I try to break it off and decide who's coming with me, obviously, out of my friends. But I'm taking a trip this year.
Where are we going?
In July. I don't know yet. I don't know.
You gonna get a passport? You got a passport?
I got a passport.
So you gotta go to Toronto.
So I'm ready. I'm ready to take a trip this year, and I'm going in July at some point, at the end of July.
All right. So I want to show you one of your peers, a gentleman by the name of Paul George. He took a trip to Greece, and he brought his Indiana Pacers uniform with him to the beach in Greece. So when you go overseas, will you be packing your own uniform?
I don't know. I don't know if I pack the own uniform, but that's funny.
I couldn't believe that one. Now, obviously, you know, you were in the playoffs, and you had that series against the Pacers. The Celtics did great. Oh, look at you guys starting to get it together. Gordon Hayward's looking good. Game one in Milwaukee. I was like, oh, this is a blowout. Like, this is a blowout on the road, and then things took a turn from there. What happened in those last four games against the Bucks?
Well, I think they made adjustments. I think it was adjustments that we couldn't get over, that we couldn't figure out how to stop as a team. And, you know, a lot of credit goes to those guys. They did a good job of packing the paint on defense. They made a lot of good emphasis to put shooters around Giannis, and, you know, it was very effective for them. And we, once they took off, they never looked back. And it was hard for us to, you know, try to change things.
Now, anybody who follows the NBA closely knows that your role dramatically changed from last year's playoffs to this year's playoffs. And that's natural because the roster was very different, especially with Kyrie Irving being healthy. And you said that this season that you had to sacrifice more than anybody. What exactly do you mean by that?
You know, just me coming in, it just wasn't the same. That's the easiest way I can put it. I'm not a guy that wants to complain and want guys to see it easy on my end, but things were just a lot different. And I'm talking far as the full season last year, and even not just the playoffs, but even last year when you take away guys like Gordon and Kyrie that goes down, I developed more opportunities to go out there and play my game and be me. And then obviously this year was just, you know, it's just kind of shorthanded because guys we got.
How hard is it to sit there on the bench and be like, I should be in a game?
I'm pretty sure a lot of guys go through that. I mean,
sure, everybody.
I did that my rookie year, you know, when I wanted to play. But you still got to pay attention to the game. You still learn a lot from guys that's playing or that have your minutes. You try to watch the game as much as you can, but I feel like everybody do that, even
that's
the
fair.
Fans.
Even I do it in my rec league, so yeah.
The guys that don't play think they can play, so that's how it goes.
So, you know, anyone who knows the game really well saw what you did last year and knew what you did in spots this year and says, well, that's a starting point guard in the NBA. And you are a restricted free agent. How important is it for you that wherever you end up, whatever uniform you end up wearing, that you are in the starting role or at least competing for it at a high level?
I mean, I feel like it's very important for me. I'm a guy that's not just settling for just being in the league or being an average player. I want to be the best version of myself. And, you know, I've been working towards that all my life since I started playing basketball. So, you know, I'm looking to start. Wherever I go, I'm looking to have that starting job. And, you know, I'm not looking to settle for anything less. I'm willing to work for it too. But, you know, that's my ultimate goal.
And, you know, when you're in the media, we see what happens on the floor. You know, we see the actual gameplay and we hear little rumors about other things. And there was so much discussion of chemistry with the Celtics and chemistry and what... I mean, do you think that chemistry was an issue with this year's team?
I mean, we had good chemistry. I mean, we was always joking around, having a lot of fun. These guys, we got a great locker room, guys that can you know, adjust to one another. But you know, we just couldn't figure it out once we got on that court, and it's hard to really point the blame, put the blame on somebody. You know, you hear a lot of guys blaming our coach, our Kyrie. You know, they just try to go online and blame people, but it's hard to really put that finger on one person. I feel like all together as a group, we just couldn't figure it out when we wanted to.
Mm-hmm. So you're a restricted free agent. You know, you're going to be getting a lot of phone calls. You'll be on, your agent's probably already hit you 7 times today. You know what I mean? There's going to be, especially when we get into July. The latest report is there's a team interested in your services potentially. The New York Knickerbockers, right here in New York City. The greatest city in the world, playing in the world's most famous arena, the mecca of basketball. You could tell I've got, you know, I'm interested in the Knicks here. You know, could you see yourself living here in New York City and playing for the New York Knicks?
Yeah, I definitely can. I definitely can. You know, this is a great organization. You know, everybody know about the New York Knicks. Their sports market and everything about it. Everybody know about the city of New York. You know, it'd be great. It'd be great.
So, you know, there's a lot of teams that are going to be looking to add you to the roster, and including the Celtics looking to keep you. What do you look for when evaluating these potential opportunities?
Like I mentioned, just looking for a team that's going to let me be myself, a team that treats me like family, and, you know, we just go from there. I'm not a hard person to work with. You know, I'm a team guy, team first type of guy, and, you know, so whoever I decide to make that decision with, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be great.